The Holocaust was the most systematic attempt ever to eliminate an entire people across an entire continent. And all the forces of technology were harnessed to that end. And therefore the Holocaust for me is a kind of a human abyss. It's a dark hole in human history.
This week, the country marked Holocaust Memorial Day, and for that reason, Songs of Praise has come here to the heart of the Nottinghamshire countryside, to Beth Shalom, the Holocaust Memorial Centre, where they remember the victims of one of the greatest tragedies in human history.
We call the centre Beth Shalom, which means the House of Peace. We want it to be a place of peace in memory of the victims of the Holocaust, for many of whom there is no place anywhere where their names or their families or their communities are remembered. The main focus of the centre is education. Every school child and every student that comes to the centre meets a survivor of the Holocaust, hears their story, and has a chance to talk to them about what that has come to mean to them and what it might mean to us.
My name is Mayer Bomstyk. I'm a survivor of the Holocaust. Most of my family perished in concentration camps.
Why should you, a young Christian man born 20 years after the end of the war, set up a centre in memory of the Holocaust?
Because to me as a Christian, it's important. It's important that I face the reality of the Holocaust, but also the challenge the Holocaust poses to me as an individual and as a part of a wider community. Christian people should lead the way in forging a relationship between Jewish people and Christian people. In other words, forming a partnership that can take us into the future, which is positive and constructive and show understanding, but also show a sense of respect and appreciation for the Jewish community.
Oh.
The Nazi intention was to wipe all Jews off the face of Europe. And in fact, around 6 million Jews were murdered during the Holocaust. Most of their communities were destroyed forever. But a few individuals survived. And we're going to be joining one of those survivors as he makes the very poignant and painful journey back to the small town in Poland that he last saw 57 years ago when he was just 14.
Shortly, I will be going back home. And it's a very, very sad time for me to go back there. Because I know when I get there, I won't meet any of my family, any of my friends. Everybody I knew when I was born there, all perished in the concentration camps.
Are you taking anything special with you on the journey?
I'm taking with a legacy.
Which is this?
Yes.
These words. What is that?
This is a legacy which we leave to our children and grandchildren, that they should carry on the work what we're doing now and to remember where they come from.
And where would you like to read these words?
This I would like to read. It's in my hometown. It's a gravesite which is still some of them there.
Staszów is a small town 3 hours' drive from Krakow. Thousands of Jews lived there before the war. Most of them, including many of Mayer Bomstyk's family, were murdered on one day in 1942. Now Mayer is going back to see the house where he grew up, the town square where he watched his grandparents waiting to be deported and slaughtered, and the dark cellar where he hid with his family until they were discovered and taken away to be shot.
I'm dreading where I'm going, but I've got to show it to my children, grandchildren, and what our people, our town, believed in was such a religious place.
Never say this is the final road for you. The red skies may cover all the days of blue. The hour that we long for is so near. Our step meets out the message we are here. From land so green with palms to land so white with snow, we shall be coming with our anguish and our woe. And where the trump of our blood fell on the earth, there our courage and our spirit shall rebirth. Today with our woe will fade away. But if the sun delays and in the east remains, this song that's passed for generations must maintain. For never say the road now ends for you. The red and skies may cover all the days of blue. As the hour that we long for is so near, it's at the message we are here. As the hour that we long for is so near, our step beats out the message we are here.
Three generations of the Bomstyk family are making this special journey.
I'm scared for him to go back to his home where he's seen so much happen. I'm really frightened for him. I want to see it because I've read loads of books on the Holocaust. I just want to see what it was like, what one of the towns they lived in was like.
He was like one of the quite a few who actually believed in God. He thought, well, Hashem, God has helped us through this. And so he believes in God because of that.
I think if you don't have any faith, it's a bad thing. But we have got faith. And this is what kept Mayer alive, I'm sure.
For him to be able to go back with children and with grandchildren is something wonderful. As he said all along, he's doing it for us. And I think that means a heck of a lot to him.
We'd grown up with hearing stories. I don't know sometimes if stories is the right word. Dad's been very reticent on occasion to sit down and give us a chapter and verse as to what's happened. But there's been times in the past where we've met as a family and the mood has been right and he's told us things that went on and what happened to family and friends and whatever.
Ah. Now we're here.
So there were always shops around the square?
Yeah, always.
Always shops.
Always. We had one of these shops we used to sell leather. But on a Friday afternoon, this town, what you see now, all these shops, everything open, closed. And because it was Jewish Sabbath was coming in, and Saturday, all the shops were closed. And after lunch, you could see all the people coming out of the houses in the best clothes. And we went walking around the square.
Here, on Friday, the 6th of November, 1942, all Jews from the town of Staszów and outlying villages were forced to gather by the authorities. The following day, they were to be moved from the town to be exterminated.
Still in my mind today, whenever I wake up at night, I see my grandparents sitting among this lot. Because we asked them, because they used to live in a village near ours. They lived in a village called Oshek. And we begged them to come with us because we contemplated to go into hiding. And we prepared our house to sell us. And we left food there and everything, but they were so religious. They did not believe that what's going to happen to them. I mean, we didn't realize what's going to happen to all these people, that Hitler's going to kill so many innocent people. And they were so faithful to God, they would not, they didn't think they're going to die.
And it's Sunday morning at 8 o'clock, they started marching. All the Jews, which are assembled here, approximately between 5,000 and 7,000, as they started walking down this street here.
And the street facing them?
Yes. And while they were walking, there was 150 Ukrainians were brought in specially to massacre as many as they can before they're going to reach the next town where they were going to go on wagons. Before they reached even 500 yards, there was already 170 people dead. And the people, there were people here working for a German firm called Omle. And their job was next day to assemble all the corpses to the grave.
Memory is the moral tutor of mankind. And what we don't remember, we can repeat. And I really don't believe yet the full message of the Holocaust has gone out to the world, which is basically live at peace with your neighbor, because any violence, above all murder, not only diminishes the other, it diminishes you.
In Staszów, you can still see the house on the corner where Mayer and his family lived, and the cellar where 16 people hid in terror for nearly 2 weeks.
Yeah, let's go down. Just be careful here. It's a small rooms in the place. Doesn't it like this.
You're all right. What's your toes?
Doesn't like this.
Nothing.
It's okay now.
Do you have any light down here?
Yeah.
You had candles?
Candles. We brought down plenty of candles.
But you didn't know how long you were going to be down here?
No. But we didn't use the candles. Only.
So it was pitch black all day and all night?
Yeah, because we frightened little child school.
You had how many of you in here?
16. But this wasn't here.
And what did you have in here? Had any furniture in here?
Nothing. No furniture.
Nothing.
Just the bedding.
And how long were you here for?
2 weeks. Oh, I'll tell you something. This was worse, can I tell you? Yes. Always thinking about it.
You can put it away now.
Yeah.
Yes. Put it to bed.
Yes.
One night, Mayer, as a young boy, was sent briefly out of hiding to see what was happening.
This used to be open.
All outside.
But here was a bakery, and some people lived there. You see? And here, I saw the first dead man. They lived when I went out at night. It's who here got to the other street. And when I went into their house, he was lying. He was dead.
We are coming to the end of that generation who lived through those events. So long as they have been here with us, they have told us their story. But we need that story to be told as long as human beings walk this earth. Because man's inhumanity to man is the constant danger in human existence.
The Bomstyk's hiding place was reported to the authorities and they were taken away for execution. But they were saved by a chance need for slave laborers at a German ammunition factory. Mayer's parents and brother perished through the cruelty of the work they were forced to undertake. Mayer and his sister were taken to concentration camps, but managed to survive until liberation.
We constantly have to be reminded that there are two paths, just as Moses said at the end of his life, the way of death, this one, and the way of life. And we must never forget Moses' words, choose life.
Maria Tamashiach.
to be able to go back and stand there, surrounded by his family, and say, look, I'm back here. It didn't work. You didn't win. I think is going to be a personal satisfaction to him, as well as very emotional.
Can you catch this? In the shadow of the memorial to the murdered Jewish people of my hometown, I, Mayer, son of Benjamin Ayenta Bomstyk, testify to their martyrdom and recall with nostalgia Staszów as it was, and with enduring grief as it is no longer. I remember my childhood in a community of some 7,000 Jews. Honest and hard-working folk, strong facing the water to their families. That community vanished in 1942 with deportation to concentration camp. Among them, my grandparents. I saw starvation, torture, executions, and mass graves, gas chambers, and crematoria. In this cemetery, which reposes the mortal remains of people who died peacefully in their beds, stands a memorial to those who have no graves and to the stranger have no names or faces. But I, who by the will of God survived, knew them and hand over the legacy of remembrance to the third generation, to the future.
On behalf of the martyrs of Staszów, we acknowledge the obligation of the legacy. Through our father's testimony, we are linked to that annihilated community whose echo permeates our consciousness.
To the 6 million whom the world must not forget, who call on mankind to live in peace and harmony.
Through our grandfather's memories, we share the suffering of more than 1 million children. We and our generation are their spiritual heirs.
We acknowledge the obligation to preserve the traditions in which they would have been reared had their young lives not been so brutally cut short. Traditions by which our great-grandparents lived and remained faithful even in their death.
This prayer, which is called Kel Mole Rachamim, means God who are full of compassion. And in it we ask God to bring under the shadow of his wings all those who died, so that some way we feel that they live on. You will hear that it's naturally a very mournful song, and in it you can hear so many centuries of pain and grief, and yet ultimate faith that evil will not triumph and that good will be the final.
Shalom, all mishkevoteyem, v'no mo.
what they say is that every challenge makes you grow. And maybe that's why he's grown to the stature that my dad is, because of the experiences and the challenges that he had.
So I had a very bad time up till now, you know, every night. I hope now I'll be able to sleep. And I'll know exactly how my town looks now and how fortunate I am to have survived. Don't ask me how. God must have been looking after me. That's the only thing I can say.
He says, by the will of God, he survived. Most of his, well, practically all his family didn't. And he's been left for a meaning. As far as I'm concerned, he was left for me.
The one-third of the Jewish people who were murdered in the Holocaust are part of our family, mine, and the families of every Jew alive. And therefore, for us, that is a private grief. But this day is a public education. To recognize that those who are not in our image are nonetheless in your image. We know, Almighty God, that you do not despair of humanity, and teach us like you never to lose hope, and give us the strength to build a world in which we cherish your image, mankind.